What's up guys, it's your boy Lucas here. Welcome back to another video. So glad to see you guys back here. A couple of weeks ago I made a video where I tried to recreate a photo that I found online of Grolsbeer. If you haven't seen it, I'll link it up right up here because this is a part two of that video, so go check it out and then come back to see this video. Lately I've been thinking a lot about this shot because like I said in that video, it was a good shot, but there were a couple of things that I wasn't satisfied with. So when I'm not satisfied with something, it keeps bugging me and I have to fix it. So in this video, I'm gonna show you how I fixed that shot. Let's start with the way that I did the setup this time compared to last time. So last time I was, you know, very busy with getting the shot and then filming the process. I was trying to make a video where I try to do the shot or recreate the shot. But this time I try to focus on getting the shot, like getting, you know, the photo and then filming what I was doing, but not too much, you know, focus on that part, you know, just the photo part, right? And last time what I did, it was, you know, analyze the shot and just went to work. But this time I was like, okay, what do I need to do to achieve certain part of the shot? So I broke the shot down in pieces and then tackled everything, you know, step by step. You know, I have to do this first, and then this, and then this, and then this, and then I can take the shot. Whereas last time I was like, okay, I have to do this, and then boom, take the shot quick, and you know, hope for the best. So my first step was to get the composition better this time, because last time I used my kitchen counter, which didn't have a lot of space. So I was like, I need to create space for myself. So I used my desk this time and two stools. So I put the bottle on one stool and the glass on another stool. I used a flash and I used the Yongno YN360 that I used last time. I tried to hang the other bottle that I'm trying to shoot through or to the side, because last time it was too close to the bottle, the beer bottle that I was trying to shoot, and I didn't feel like, you know, you were getting the depth that I wanted. It was like blurry, but it wasn't blurry enough. So I put it with a clamp, a small rig clamp and a small rig arm, to a line stand, and then I can move it, you know, front to back or tilt it, whatever I want to do with it. I had the room to do that, whereas last time I only could move it front and back and a little to the side because the space of the kitchen counter wasn't big enough. So that part, that problem was solved. The next problem was trying to get the lighting right. I made a snoot out of cardboard with gaffer tape because I was trying to direct the light onto the label of the bottle. That didn't work out, so I 86 that one. I tried to use a diffuser to shoot the light through. That didn't work out. I tried to like aim it to the wall, bouncing the light off the wall through the diffuser. That didn't work. So I tried a bunch of things that didn't work out. I moved the light to the side also, used a diffuser. That didn't, like, you know, give me the lighting that I wanted. So I was like, okay, it was time to go to a softbox. I didn't want to put the softbox together, but I had to do it. So then I thought, let's just swap the lights. So I put the flash on the left side of the bottle and then put the Yongno stick light on the right side of the bottle. The lighting was better, but now I had to face another problem, which was that the bottle was getting a lot of light. And if you look at the original shot, you can see that on the left side, it was darker than on the right side. So what I did is use gaffer tape to block the light from coming from the left side of the bottle, and that actually worked. I moved on to opening the bottle and tried to get the beer cap to hang, not against the bottle, but, you know, just hang. However, the bottle cap of this bottle was upside down, so the Grols name was upside down. So I had to switch it with another bottle, or actually pour the beer in an empty bottle which had the Grols written right. I had to do that first before I can proceed to taking the photo. If I took the photo with the Grols beer or the Grols name upside down, it would have irritated me because I wanted to fix this, and after fixing it you still see like Grols upside down. It would have been like, you know, irritating. So I had to fix that. So I did that and swapped the light on the right for a reflector because I didn't like how much light it was getting from the right. So I swapped it for the reflector to, you know, get more of a soft lighting. Now that I was happy with the composition and the lighting, it was time for me to fill up the beer glass, turn off the light that I wasn't going to use, and then take the shot. First, let me show you the raw and the edited version side by side, and then I'm going to compare this shot to the one that I did before. This one is better in my opinion than the last one because I paid more attention to details and it looks better. It just looks better than the last one. I would definitely show this to a client so they can see how I do product photography, but the last one, I wouldn't. The point of this video was to show you guys that I fixed the shot, and I wanted you to know that if you're not satisfied with something and if you know you can do it better, you know, try to do it better. Try to fix it. Don't just settle for what you did the first time. You know, it's not always that the first shot is the best shot. You know, if you don't like it, fix it. If you don't like something you create, something you're doing in life, whatever you're doing, it's not just for photography or videography, whatever you're doing, if you don't like the version that you did or the version that you're doing right now, fix it. You know, you'll be happy about it. You'll feel better about yourself. Just fix it. That's it for this video. Hope you guys enjoyed it as much as I did and learned something in the process. Don't forget to smash the like button. You know, break it. Help me reach more people. You know, smash that like button. Leave a comment. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. You know, turn on the notification bell. Follow me on my social media. Links are in the description down here. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.